Good morning, everyone. We are back in the shop, and I've already been here for a little bit. I got here pretty early this morning, just wanted to get going, I guess. So we have been making good progress on this thing. As you guys saw in the last video, we got a good way forward on this build, closer to getting the first startup on this thing. Those of you just tuning in, we just got the car back from Ranch Built, got the turbo kit all modified and rebuilt to fit the Forester. This does still have that GD front mount kit on it. The only thing that had to change was dropping it down a couple inches. Other than that, the piping would have fit perfectly. So if you're looking for a front mount for your Forester, know that 02 to 07 WX or STI one will fit with minor modifications. Rotated kit, obviously you guys know this thing started off as an ETS kit, but we did go ahead and actually rebuild it since the ETS kit had a previous hood exit. We now have a new downpipe. Since we were building a new downpipe, I went ahead and modified the placement of the turbo, which we're gonna have to do anyways for our AMS. So jumping forward, yesterday we were getting done on the fuel system, getting done all the little tedious things on this thing, running errands and getting parts. Now that we have all those parts, I'm finally able to make some good progress on this thing. I did go ahead and finish up the fuel system this morning. That is 100% in. I do need to tie some things up here still, but she is in. This will not be crooked when it's done. It'll be straight for my guys that are just as picky. Lines are already built, connected, and it looks like I got a decent glare on the camera, so I apologize. We do need to get this stuff powder coated in the future. I know Brian's gonna really give me shit for this right now, because I'm probably just gonna paint that black for now, just until we get the stuff powder coated. And to be honest, you guys, I don't see myself getting the stuff powder coated until I have to pull this thing back apart. So if we lose the motor on the dyno, then she's getting powder coated right away. If she wants to live, I guess we're gonna have to live with no powder coat for now. Like I said, I got the fuel system done this morning. Now it's down to running our vacuum lines. I already got the boost controller hooked up. I do need to hook up the reference to the manifold, our fuel pressure reference, and like I said, just little things. The starter needs to go in. We need to put fluid in the transmission. You guys already know that what fluid we're gonna put in the trans. Like I said, if you're just tuning in, this car does have a full STI drivetrain now. And obviously we are gonna put our own cocktail in here for the transmission. If some of you guys have seen this in the past, if you do want to go ahead and get this for your car, you can definitely pick this up on our website, which is linked down below. But we're going to be putting some lightweight shockproof and Redline 7590 mixture into our transmission. They'll keep her shifting nice and buttery smooth. I do need to put that crank pulley on this morning, so I'm going to be pulling that off and getting that modified. I'll show you guys what we need to modify there. As far as that, I mean, I think, or like I said, we're pretty damn close right now. So I'm gonna finish running some of these vacuum lines. That stuff's kind of hard to show. And I'm gonna finish routing the AOS since I'm pretty close on that. Yeah, I'm gonna do that stuff real quick. And then once I get that done, I'll go ahead and check back up you and we'll knock out that pulley. So you see here, here's the stock crank pulley, and you can see it has like a release spot for the timing cover. And then we put our fluid dampener over here and it has no relief, so that's why you do need to trim the timing cover. So if you look here, you can see the lipped edge, so that lipped edge needs to come off. I wouldn't recommend cutting this with like let me see if I can find them, like these, because if you do that, then it starts to chip away and you'll end up breaking the cover. I would recommend either A, using like a cutoff flat cut this, or use a whiz tool and grind it down. One of those two ways is what's gonna work best. I'm gonna go ahead and have Chase do it. Once he's all finished up, then you guys will see it all nice and flat, and we'll get that pulley put on. You see what happens when things escalate?
Vroom, vroom.
Oh boy. So, since we don't care about this bumper, some of you might cringe that need this bumper, but I've already cut it. So we're gonna go ahead and make this better foaming.
Race cut.
Until bumper. We put that JDM STI bumper on the thing. Then I ain't gonna do that. Oh boy. This will be our race bumper, baby.
Yeah, this is the bumper that we don't give two shits or one about.
All right. Rest in peace. Well, things just got real.
Yeah, real big.
First time you ever said that, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's sit down there. See how much better this looks.
This is about to be fucking bad.
It might be tough because I know the grill sits underneath of it. Might have to actually pull the damn grill back out, but I don't remember. Yeah, because the grill sits in front of it. There you go.
Eject the grill.
There. Put it down. Damn.
That's a pretty fat cut. I think we should still go some more.
What, up?
Yeah.
We can only go so much more because, I mean, we can definitely go up more, but we're losing all our rigidity in our bumper.
Yeah.
She's about to be in two pieces.
Yeah. That's how they have to ship them when they ship the US, or the JDM front, so we might as well make this a JDM front.
It looks a lot better.
I definitely say...
Yeah, it needs the side to come out. To go with the other spot.
We have to go with that other spot and then just bring it up. And then I guess that line is about perfect because it looks kind of dumb having that.
Well, yeah. So we got to get that off. That's just for where the plate used to be, but.
Yep.
Damn.
I definitely feel like that looks a lot better. And okay, let's close the hood for you guys.
Oh boy, that's going to be a mission. I don't know.
Got to work fast.
You work fast? That's the first time I ever heard that. Come along. I'll get some clamps since the ones Justin's brought yesterday are all pretty rusty. They're not nice enough for the Forester anymore. So we gotta go get some new clamps.
The Forester just turned bougie, so we need. Mmm. Oh yeah.
What, now you like Foresters?
No, I still want a CRV, but...
Wow.
The Forester's growing on me a little bit.
Look at that front mount gain.
Dude.
Gain.
I'm sorry, but if I were to pull up on somebody with this, they'd probably shit their pants. Like, they'd wonder, like, what's done to this thing. They'd think that would be an inner fooler and it's just bone stock, but when they hear that choo-choo-choo, they're definitely going to shit their pants.
Well, lunchtime.
Lunchtime.
So while Chase is finishing up the front timing covers there, I'm getting ready to add our special sauce into the transmission. Yeah, that's what we need. I'm gonna shake it up a little bit. Now, here you go. I'm gonna go ahead and get this in trans. Boost controller is 100% wired in and done. And timing cover is all back on. Everything's coming together. We went and got some new clamps for the intercooler here. I think we're coming down to the final touches. That means first start, hopefully today. That's if Chase didn't wire the fuel system wrong. That's a lie. That's a bold-faced lie. Chase is 100% wired fuel system wrong.
When I first started, I was pretty bad, but.
We'll see. We'll see here soon. Fluid dampener is on, looking good. Almost the best looking part on this motor. So, now we can go ahead, we gotta hook up the AC dog.
Who's here?
That's a good question. Who
sounds
is here?
Sounds like something that can't run. Sounds like it needs to be.
Damn, it shut off like instantly.
Yeah, let's go see what that is.
I don't know what that was. All right, guys, we jumped pretty far ahead here in hopes to get this first start done before we're ending out this video. Really wanted to do that for you guys. There is a couple things that we do still need to tie up and finish some odds and ends. One being you're gonna notice a hose here. This is for the coolant overflow. Don't have an overflow, so I just have it going to the ground right now. Just for the first startup, I will get an overflow on the car. We still need to set fuel pressure, but like I said, we haven't even started this thing yet. We did go ahead and prime the fuel system. Trans is full. Motor is full of oil, power steering is full. So it is now time. You ready to hear what this thing sounds like or what?
Just ready to make some sauce.
Now, we're on the edge of how much fuel's in the car. There's only a couple gallons of fuel in the car. I know we drained a tank. We can hear it right now. When we had the key on and testing, there was no fuel leaks. We can hear that it does have fuel, but it's kind of on the edge. Mm-hmm. Definitely should go get some fuel.
Yeah, we need at least another three, four gallons.
But we're still gonna try to start it for you boys to end this video out. You wanna go ahead and grab the gauge off the Civic. We need to set the fuel pressure up on this thing. That way we have a good release to start. It should be pretty close, but just might as well check. And we will do this first startup, boys. See what this homie Tome sounds like. Yeah. On the Forester STI. God, the Civic, she's so beautiful. I don't usually take parts from her, but she's getting a fuel pressure sensor now anyway, so we'll go ahead and take our nice IAG gauge there. Just wrapping up, getting that fuel pressure gauge put on there. And it's time. First startup. Is this a good time to say that I forgot to put my E85 cold start enrichment table on it? Damn. Forgot this thing's on E85 only.
She gonna be
we'll see. It's pretty cold in the shop right now. 57 degrees is what it says in here, and it's about zero or negative outside.
Yeah.
It's pretty damn cold in here, so we'll see what happens. You ready?
Yeah. I'm
gonna go hold the camera. Ready. You wanna watch for oil leaks?
Yeah.
Like here.
Can I get a cold start?
No leaks, baby.
We got bleeded power steering, so that's what you guys will probably be hearing. But boy, holy, does that homie Tome sound good? I promise you guys, it does not have cams in it. I don't know why it's doing that. That homie Tome sound like it got cams in this thing. Damn, she sounds good. Oh. We got one baby oil leak.
Damn.
We gotta find out where that guy's coming from.
But, yeah, she's a pretty good leaker. It looks like it's off the back of the, back of the head, but
ain't no way.
We'll get right back with you guys.
The banjo.
Yeah.
So guys, it's leaking at the back of the head, way back there, and you're not gonna be able to see, but you're gonna have to take my word for it. It's coming from the back of the head, right where the oil feed to the turbo is going. So Chase is just checking it to see if it got left loose or what's going on with that, but it fired right up. I was kind of surprised. Let's see how we're doing on our fluid. We definitely have power steering fluid. It's just gonna have to bleed itself. That system hasn't been ran in quite some time. But, does it feel tight?
I can't even really get on it.
I swear I tightened that thing. Maybe you can see down there where his hand is. Oh, well, you took my light away now. I can see your hand.
It's kind of difficult to push. Oh, she was definitely loose.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh. There we go.
Your boy put that on. All right, well, at least you know it was truly a first start. Does it feel tight now?
Yeah, that does.
Okay, let's see if she fires right back up, and we'll see. It looked like it was definitely rich. That's why it was loping. I didn't take a glance at the wideband there. This is just a quick base map I put on the car, so we'll see.
We might have a little baby exhaust leak.
Yeah, well, it's got a seat too.
Yeah, we'll let her seat and do her thing. Give me that camera. All right, so now here is for the second cold start for the boys. We're getting our kinks out. I could make the power steering noise go away, but man, does she sound good, guys. She sounds really good. Let's see if we can get this power steering to go away.
Yeah, chases are bleeding the power steering, guys. This thing was 100% drain. So to bleed this, you have to have it up in the air and you crank it all the way to one way and then all the way to the other way. So that's what he's doing right now. It's gonna start sucking that fluid down. Grab our light and look. Oh yeah, we got fluid in there. So it is doing its job. This custom reservoir I had on Hyper Blue, and it was always kind of a pain. It would always make noise when it was quiet, and then the moment the car warmed up, it would go away and it was fine. But the end result, guys, is this ain't fired right up. It looks like it's running really good now. I got the fuel pressure set, got it bumped up. It's at a 50 PSI base. Thing is sounding good. Tomy don't sound too bad. It's a NVIDIA N1, guys, if you're curious what exhaust. Damn, this pump is going to town. Just let it sit there. Just let it sit there. That way it's good. It's gonna take a while. Doing good. Need to pull a little bit of fuel out of it. You can see there. It's like 12.2. It's still warming up. Still bleeding the coolant. He's still going. Starting to get quieter. Just gonna take some time. Looks like there's still fluid in there. Yeah, there's still fluid in there. Maybe I'll seal it off. See if that helps. Maybe that'll help. There you have it, boys. First start out of the way. It's definitely low on fuel. While we were sitting here, it started to dip down and start to almost sound like it was down a hole, and then you give it gas and it would try to break up. So definitely need to go get some more fuel for this thing, but we got that oil leak taken care of. Everything checks out, car fires right up. So I'm gonna take that as a win.
Yeah, everything, I mean, other than fuel, if we had fuel, everything would go smooth, but we might have to get the injectors cleaned out. They are used, but everything else other than that is went pretty smooth. So
I guess we are going to be going to Ranchville. So I got to pull these injectors out. Damn, these things are a pain in the ass to pull out.
They're not that bad. Mm. They're not that
bad. You didn't do this side with that harness?
Yeah, those are pretty bad.
It was not fun. So I'm happy, guys. I'm happy to be able to do the first start in this video for you guys, keeping this series as quick as I can going. I'm surprised at how quick it fired right up. Literally 2 seconds fired right up. So happy to see that. That's going to wrap today up. Might end up being a little bit shorter video, but hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And I know we did. We have a little bit of other things to do to this thing. Obviously, we have some things to do in the engine bay. I want to raise it up to go through everything, make sure everything's tight. This thing just went through more changes than it was supposed to, so it's gonna wrap this up. Wife's giving me dirty looks right now. So
no, because of him.
Dude, they look good. They look
the wife wanna show the camera?
I saw your Tylenol.
You can't even talk.
Fuck off.
We out. We out. The wife just got braces today. And I feel like I'm dating my high school girlfriend now again.
You like that.
Hell
yeah.
She's Darla. I'm a piranha.
He almost said the other word. You see how quick she got pissed off at you?
No,
I said Barb. Goodbye.
See ya.
Bye. Hey.
living life up in the fast lane. Living life up in the fast lane. Up in the fast lane.
Pedal to the ground, pedal to the ground, pedal to the ground.
Living life up in the fast lane.
Life though your limits, you just put them in Coronas, Coronas, Coronas. I've been working, working, I need that advance with the bonus, the bonus, the bonus. Ain't no thoughts about tomorrow, I'm just living in the moment, the moment, the moment. Full tank of gas and 200 on the dash, bitch I'm zoning. I'm zoning, I'm zoning, fast lane.
Living life up in the fast lane. Living life up in the fast lane.
Living life up in the fast lane, fast lane. And I ain't slowing down, I ain't slowing down, I ain't slowing down.
Living life up in the fast lane.
Pedal to the ground, pedal to the ground, pedal to the ground.